Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to this new episode of Swift Quiz. This time, we're going to talk about the subtleties of subscripting a dictionary. So let's take a look at the code. I've defined a dictionary that contains three pairs of keys and values. The keys are 0, 1, and 2, and the values are strings, which contain spelled out versions of the key. And then on the line just after, you can see that I am subscripting my dictionary with a key that the dictionary does not contain. And so the question I want to ask is, do you think this code will crash? If it were an array instead of a dictionary, there's no doubt about it, the code would most certainly crash. But what's the case of a dictionary? Is it allowed to subscript a dictionary with a key that it doesn't contain? What do you think? As always, there's a very easy way for us to get the answer. I just have to run the code and see what happens. And as you can see, unlike with an array, this time my code didn't crash and the subscript operator simply returned nil because it couldn't find the key 3 inside the dictionary. And so that's the big difference between subscripting an array and subscripting a dictionary. When you subscript an array, the subscript operator will return a non-optional value, which is arguably easier to manage in your code. But the downside is that if the index you provided to the subscript operator is not found, then your app will crash. On the other hand, with a dictionary, the subscript operator will return an optional value, meaning that if you provide a key that is not contained in the dictionary, then the subscript operator will simply return nil. Of course, there might also be some situations where you need to subscript a dictionary, but you also don't want to deal with optional values. And in such a situation, you can actually provide a default value to the subscript operator. So here I'm providing the string missing as the default value. And what's going to happen is that now if I run my subscript operator with a key that is not contained inside the dictionary, instead of returning nil, the subscript operator will now return my default value. So to see it in action, I'm just going to run my code once more. And as you can see, this time the subscript operator has returned the string missing. And so now the subscript operator is no longer returning an optional value, but just a value because it has a default value for the cases where it couldn't find the key I will provide. All right, that's all for this video. I hope you've enjoyed it and maybe learned a thing or two about the subtleties of subscripting a dictionary in Swift. Thanks for watching and see you next time.